and welcome back to Whassup Wrestling. Here we are here for our 100th episode spectacular. 100 episodes specials and what a grand achievement. Go, recording. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to This is Whassup Wrestling here for our 100th episode. And I am not alone here on the announce desk.
Contest is an eight-woman battle royal. Making her way to the ring from Bray, Ireland, Erin.
The moment this match was announced, the WWE Universe has expected a classic. I think it is destined to deliver.
Really? I don't think so. I mean, this match is only just announced a few moments ago there, Cole. Maybe try again. Erin Reed, who is actually a competent competitor here in Whassup Wrestling, trained, of course, by Kyo, or at least recently, former number one contender in the Vixens Championship.
She knows how to prove herself in the women's division.
Well, she certainly does, as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted. She is a very competitive fighter. She has been rather on an undefeated streak during her initial run, but when she went up with Hollywood Haley J, her luck certainly ran out. Byron, Corey, you got anything to say? Any generic lines about, you know, how she looks ready for this one? No? She's going to leave it to me?
And from New Zealand, Holly Madison.
We talk a lot about locker room dynamics. You'll never hear a single negative thing backstage about this superstar.
Well, very
what
true.
What happens when you treat your fellow superstars with respect? They respect you right back.
There are no awards for congeniality here in WWE. That respect means nothing if you lose.
A competitor who is always laser focused on the competition. I expect big things from her tonight.
Well, here's hoping. I mean, she is also the leading force behind the Team Resistance taking on the council in just a few weeks' time at Survivor Series. So we will see if her good deeds indeed prove fruitful, or as you were mentioning there, Byron, or I believe Corey. Yes, Corey. Whether or not they will be detrimental to her.
And from Carson City, Nevada, Roxie Stevenson.
It's one that the locker room has wanted to see. It's one that the WWE Universe has wanted to see. It's one that I've been waiting to see, and it's about to go down.
Well, Roxie Stevenson certainly has a colored history here in Whassup Wrestling, coming in as a bouncy former stripper turned wrestler, now the personification of, in her opinion, womanhood. She is the women's champion in her mind and heart. She is what every woman should strive to be.
Big match, and she knows everyone backstage will be watching her make an impact.
Okay, Corey, if you interrupt me again, I swear to God, I'm going to leap over this table and just rip your throat out. And okay, no, we'll calm down here because I'm not by the table, ladies and gentlemen. No, I'm in my own little booth. Happy and safe and sound. So. Well, here comes one of the potential wild card entrants.
Head, Saxton, show some respect for the queen.
Only time I bow my head is when my neck hurts.
And from Queens, New York.
I get it.
Queen Zelina.
All right, I'm going to leave it to you guys.
Zelina possesses over a decade of experience in the ring.
Yeah, you may not like her attitude, but Queen Zelina is a true student of the game. She knows every trick in the book, and knowing those tricks has brought her great success.
What is wrong with Queen Zelina's attitude, Saxton?
Nothing.
Like a real peasant.
Give me about 4 hours, and I'll tell you.
I don't know. She was able to defeat Queen Amazonia in the first round of the Queen of the Ring matchup. A certain surprise, the smallest competitor defeating the biggest.
Called themselves the queen, but Zelina is the only one with the crown.
We'll see how another queen feels once she enters this ring. And we'll see how quickly Zelina is able to last, or if she just eliminates herself.
Oh,
Already she has a worried look on her face.
The man is here.
A competitor who never backs down from a fight. And from Dublin, Ireland, Becky Lynch. She is as tough as they come.
Yeah, these days the outfits may be a little fancier, but the passion in Lynch remains the same.
Perhaps the most popular competitor in women's division history.
Well, we'll see how she stacks up to the best of the best in Whassup Wrestling. She's got three bona fide Whassup wrestlers inside the ring with her, all of which will be looking for an opportunity to dethrone her.
A Hall of Fame career simply because she has believed in herself every step of the way.
And we got plenty of competitors on the outside who believe in themselves as well. And as I was saying, anyone who can eliminate Becky Lynch will certainly have a feather in their cap for sure. Here comes the potential challenger to Zelina's crown.
Has arrived. Behold her majesty.
Well, technically, Zelina is already here.
From the Queen City, the SmackDown Women. Personification of majestic elegance, a fearless defender of her crown.
Were you just drooling over Zelina earlier?
We'll bow down to her.
There's no question Charlotte is WWE royalty, but Charlotte often lacks compassion for those around her.
Well, that comes with the territory when you've been superior most of your life. Flair says she's proud to be a queen and she should be celebrated.
She ever won Queen of the Ring?
Also embarrass and humiliate those who choose not to fall in line.
Well, she also has history in Whassup Wrestling. She was one of the competitors in the first ever Whassup Wrestling WWE crossover event, where she faced off and defeated Emily Stratfield at Fastlane. A pay-per-view that was determined to show.
Proudly pulls the strings as the puppet master of the women's division, and will gladly accept anyone who will bow down.
She created her own divine right as the queen
and intends to cause great pain and suffering to her opposition.
You just can't game plan for this type of brilliance.
You just said that she had no love lost for anyone else around. Now you're saying that anyone who accepts her as a queen, She accepts.
She is a woman who is here to take control.
And representing Damage Control from San Jose, California, Bayley.
Now, Bayley claims that she's the one that built the women's division.
It's a claim Bayley has every right to make. She's the longest reigning SmackDown Women's Champion in history at 379 days. Listen, Bayley couldn't be more aggressive. She couldn't be more vicious. And she claims she's a role model for all the women in WWE.
I can't believe Bayley has gone so far as to shave the name of her rival in the back of her head. Who does that?
I can't see it.
Well, those of us that have hair to work with Saxton generally try to do mind games like that.
At the same time, I think the women's division has been around for a lot longer than Bayley.
She is physically and mentally prepared for the task at hand in tonight's match.
Saxon, don't speak unless spoken to. God damn it. One more competitor to go.
Time for some Stratisfaction.
And their opponent from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Trish Stratus.
Trish Stratus, always hungry to take on the best of the best. Always hungry to take on the absolute top competition in WWE.
Stratisfaction guaranteed.
Well, given the way that you guys were kissing ass on Bayley.
Trish has won a lot of matches and looked great doing it. An amazing mix of beauty and brawn.
They're slobbering all over Trish. Jesus Christ, guys.
This battle royal is underway. Superstars will be eliminated until only one winner remains.
Thank you, Cole.
Nothing like a battle royal. You have to be smart, resilient, and most importantly, opportunistic.
Well, Roxie is just punching the air. It's not really opportunistic there.
Talk about devastation.
Decimating the knee.
Oh, ouch.
Snap suplex.
Little on little attacks here.
Oh,
Becky
backfire.
Reliving her feud with Flair there.
And for some reason, she stops the count.
What do you mean stops the count? It's a battle royale, Cole. You just called it.
Uh-oh.
Jesus. Hip toss there from Lynch. Becky and Flair trying to keep up their fight.
Forearm to the face. Oh, nothing fancy about that. Might take her head clean off her shoulders.
Just about. Damn, man.
All measured up.
No elimination attempt so far.
Oh,
spoke too soon.
This is ridiculous. This is insulting.
This is entertaining.
No eliminations yet. All eight competitors still in here.
Interesting.
Corey, I said, shut up.
Set up for this. She's doing whatever she can to escape, but she does.
Hairpin slam. Staved off that attack. Placed in the corner.
Just reading the names off of this, aren't you?
Snap the finger. She's starting to look concerned. Landing with a bulldog. Right.
Who's looking concerned?
Right to the kidneys from behind. Dragon screw.
Okay, you guys are just calling random moves off the creator wrestler list, aren't you?
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Well, Lynch there going for Bayley. Summer and Roxie scouted. Keeping up.
These two showing how well scouted they each are.
Zelina playing possum, I suppose. Otherwise, so she was really taken out.
Face first with a waistlock takedown.
Bayley fighting back, not going to let Roxie in there.
Textbook neck breaker.
Bayley in full control here with a Bayley flex.
Some are taken down. No submissions, though.
It's locked in. This one went. And can she break out back to her feet? A couple of elbows to the gut and create separation.
Flair retaliating.
And oh! I believe that was. Is that Bayley? Yes, Bayley eliminated. You guys aren't even going to call that.
Kick places her right in the corner. Oh my! She is just desperately trying to fight out of it.
Another tiny fight over by the ropes.
She's got her cinched in.
Zelina actually smaller than Summer.
Baseball slide drop kick.
Or just a baseball slide. Otherwise known as.
And around we go. Tilt-a-whirl head scissors. Oh, right to the spine with a knee.
That was vicious.
So if you're keeping count, it is four Whassup Wrestling to three WWE.
She's fighting back. Oh my God, what an elbow.
Or perhaps.
Frankensteiner.
5-2 again. Don't know where Trish is standing. But Erin might not be alone here for long.
Right after the neck. The chain kick for Trish.
These two trading counters and an absolute masterclass. Snap suplex.
Ooh, the chick kick versus the cat's meow. What's going to come out there?
Becky in full control here.
There it is. Manhandle slam.
And toss her over the top rope.
Opened up an opportunity.
That offense really hitting her hard.
Zelina will come back after that.
Well, not for a little while, at least. Erin looking to take out Flair, perhaps.
Uh-oh, watch out! Double rusted leg sweep!
A little team up from Flair, or sorry, Erin and
ripped down
Lynch.
The canvas. Oh no, stop the arm! Uh-oh,
well scattered by Charlotte.
There it is again. Exact same inflection. Are you guys robots?
Becky Lynch setting up for the bench blower suplex.
Ooh, that hurt right in the kidney,
golly.
Shot from behind and. Backbreaker taken down.
Oh,
far. We have not seen any elimination attempt for a little while here.
Down. What is this superstar looking for?
Legs are... Uh-oh, this is not going to look pretty. Submission being applied. Oh, face first.
This one is all over. Maneuver out. And successfully. Oh, wow. Impactful, too.
Pair of counters from submission holds, though, just to wear down the opponents.
What a leg sweep.
She begins to stir back up, but doesn't look good.
Oh, no, stopped in the arm.
She wants to put an end to things here.
And Erin poised, ready, waiting, pulls somewhere down.
Takedown, step through, looking for a submission here.
Legs she's going for a submission.
We've
seen it too before.
That belongs on a highlight reel.
Able to eliminate. And that was an effective attack, guys.
Becky Lynch almost being eliminated here from the smallest competitor.
Stages of this matchup. Who's going to dig deeper at this point?
It might just take that extra push, that extra inch further to create the difference.
Just a hefty shot on Roxie, keeping her up on the top. No one taking advantage, though.
She sent flying into the corner.
Lynch is feeling it, has Charlotte square in her sights.
Charlotte able to steer clear.
And that holds Becky back.
Overhand right lands.
And Roxie now hops off.
Okay,
no elimination since Bayley.
Himself to the ropes.
Dragon Slayer.
She's trying one more time.
And blindside on Trish.
Stratus is completely out of it. Another big move.
And another flying.
What a great.
Another blindside this time to Erin. And Zelina into the corner.
Oh, man.
Zelina back into the corner.
Becky Lynch on the move.
No tie up Roxie and Becky. Straight down, reverse DDT. And Erin just fighting her back into the ropes, towards the ropes. Now turning her attention to Trish. Blonde on blonde action here.
Takes their breath out. Effective counter. And another one. Incredible.
Erin just really showing off her strength.
Quite an effective counter.
This is one of that knee drop, though. And Becky Lynch almost eliminated here. Roxie over the top rope.
By natural selection.
Bow to the crown.
It's summer, though.
She will wisely return to the ring now.
That's because no one was paying attention to Roxie.
Beating up the WWE Universe.
This place is starting to rock.
And Erin now again.
Looking for a submission here.
Sharpshooter stomp.
Legs are locked up.
This one has to be over.
Damn, you've done it to everyone in this matchup so far.
Setting up, rolling through.
And Zelina now.
That's it.
Why close to the eliminated camp. And Zelina is eliminated. And Roxy's in trouble as well.
And she's gone after her opponent's core a few times now.
You guys want to call some of these eliminations? Or am I on my own here?
The attack completely.
And now down to five.
Taken down. What
I'm sorry, six.
Legs are great.
I can count.
The arms are this won't end well. Oh, face first.
And Roxie is eliminated as well.
Uh-oh, she has trouble coming. Not going to be easy to get out of this.
Interesting strategy utilizing a submission in a Royal Rumble match, but it's effective right now.
Oh, no, stop to the arm.
Well, now you're actually talking about
position
holds intelligently. Anytime they happen during the Rumble, it's like, oh my god, submission holds, why? And oh, from behind, Summer. Oh, with the arm twisted, heading for the ropes. Very dangerous here.
Series of elbows looking to create separation. She does so.
Runs right through with the spear.
Ooh, point of the elbow counters that.
Ooh.
And Summer inverted Hurricanrana.
Frankensteiner.
Injury
She'll get sent out the and Becky Lynch is eliminated now. Just got clobbered. Down to four. Two WWE, two Whassup wrestlers.
Man, this place is jumping. There they go.
It's Summer. Well, keep planning your assault for Survivor Series there, Summer.
Wearing down the knee and the elbow, too.
I agree. Technically, the last representative here from Whassup Wrestling.
Gets that turn back on her.
And Charlotte Flair sits to the ropes, and again, drop and Erin with a low drop kick.
Queen changes the direction of that one.
He's firing up, no doubt about it. Setting up, rolling through.
Kona silent.
He's not going to settle for this. She's doing whatever she can to escape, and she does. Boom. Oh, man, just punishing.
So it is the three of the four blondes that we've had in this matchup. Face. I don't know what that means.
Buster. Escape just in time. Double leg takedown. Step through looking for a submission here. Legs are locked up. Uh-oh. Oh, face first. So much brutality with that move tonight.
What? Erin countering out. Brings Charlotte up. Huge elimination attempt.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner. She perhaps returns here, but the favor there.
Charlotte countering out, the fighting back.
Lock applied. Nice suplex.
Now focusing in on Trish.
And here we go now. Drops the elbow. Oh, what a right. Yeah, that's an attitude behind it. Boot to the stomach gives them separation. Slap! Oh, no, you didn't.
Yes, she did. Flair delivering the chop.
Natural selection.
What the hell are you guys talking about?
Boom! We could have an elimination here.
And Charlotte up on the top. Could be saying goodnight. Erin Rhea going to step back and just watch, wait. Trish, though, fighting back.
Big backdrop.
And Charlotte from behind, but Erin unable to catch sight of her.
Natural selection. That has got to be the one.
And Erin may be saying goodnight here. Being brought to the ropes. Charlotte building up speed, and good night, Erin.
Getting respect from her subjects in attendance.
And Trish trying to come in from behind, but Charlotte ready.
She's on unsteady legs in the corner, needs to recover.
And up goes Trish. Trish trying to hold on, but not doing a good job. And out she goes.
Would you look at... Yes, Charlotte wins! Here's another look at some of the previous action, giving their fans their money's worth and more.
So tremendous matchup here. Trent is way to open up Whassup Wrestling 100. Whassup Wrestling superstars putting on the fight of their life.
Here's
but once
winner,
again,
Charlotte Flair.
Charlotte wins out over Whassup Wrestling.
Celebrating this match and the winner. With that win, they deserve the praise. This win tonight may have been a career-defining moment. They're definitely celebrating like it was.
We'll see if anyone else from Whassup Wrestling will ever step up to Flair. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are, Violence John, and who I'm being told is Uncle Howdy. This will be one hell of a matchup, both men fighting to a brawl. And just like before, I am not alone here. I am actually joined by perhaps the better commentator than all three of the others combined, I will say. Jojo, welcome here. And yes, well, of course I'm here there, Weasel. You think I'm going to be missing out on the 100th episode? Whassup Wrestling would be nothing without the Jojo. Well, here's hoping that people who come in hearing that gruff voice aren't going to be turned off across it. And, oh, little sign there straight across the throat from Uncle Howdy. Gotta wonder whose uncle he is. I mean, is he everyone's uncle? Of course he's everyone's uncle. It's in the name, damn it. Otherwise, everyone would just call him Howdy. Stiff shot there to Violence John, who made a name for himself in backstage brawls. In fact, it's basically how he debuted here. Going so far as to put Cracker Jack on the injury list for damn near an entire year. These two did manage to settle things. And straight steel chair shot, but Howdy rolls away and just stands there, sees the clothesline coming, and says, I can take it. So JoJo Survivor Series is coming on up next month. Any predictions on the War Games matchup? Yeah, it's going to be a council clean sweep. And every one of those resistance harlots will rue the day that they decided to sign up with Summer Holly Madison. Well, any predictions on who will be on which team? It doesn't really matter. All that matters is that the council will come out on top. Well, this is the Council and Harem Coalition. Yeah, but the Council is still on top. Even though the Harem does consist of your goddess. JoJo, any words? All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get back to the matchup here. Violence John now on top of things. Heading back for that steel chair, see if he has better luck with it. And misses. Howdy just absolutely obliterates his hold, but Violence John just takes the shot and comes right back. Shot to the back of the head. Oh, wait a minute. I just realized something. What's that, JoJo? That's a mask he's wearing. You can see the flesh on his neck. What the hell is this kind of cheap Halloween stuff? Well, Halloween is just a couple weeks away. Stop trying to put things together. Violence John. Hefty shots and, oh, right into the that kind of tool thing or garbage pail. Very hard to see. And Howdy just kicking the chair out of his hands. This uppercut and this thing just a brawl. And Violence John's arms twitching, glitching. Yeah, I'm not certain what he's hoping to do here with that. I'm not really getting his style here. And if anything, it's more of a detriment. He should probably stop that. Yeah, he hasn't gotten any form of combat back. In fact, now it's kind of looking a bit freaky. I don't know, Violence John maybe just be, or maybe it's Uncle Howdy just kind of seeping into his mind, making it clear that Violence John is just a puppet and the strings have been cut. Either that or Violence John is attempting to do and Violence John now just beating Howdy with his shoulder. And just sort of leans to the side. Shaky grip still, and those spine buster straight on the concrete. And Violence John, it's like a part of him is being pulled towards Howdy. Not sure how, I mean, I suppose passing the steel chair through his body is somehow pushing the violent tendencies of his own spirit into it. His knee to the gut, and Howdy perhaps trying to put Violence John out of his misery. And Violence John's body just flopping about. This is just what happens when you take on Uncle Howdy in a backstage area. You don't see, oh, what is this? Somehow Violence John getting Howdy up and power bombs him down. And Violence John zombifies, now just creepy.
Whassup Wrestling is brought to you by
Facebook.
Whassup Wrestling is brought to you by Snacky S'mores. The Snacky S'mores.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bell, jingle all the way. The horns of death run loose tonight, they rip, they bite the sleigh.
The following is a men's War Games match.
Yay!
The rules of the match are as follows. Two teams will be contained in separate cages, with one member of each team starting the match. At regular intervals, alternating members from each team will be released to enter the match. The team with the advantage will be the first to have a member released into the match. Once all competitors have entered, War Games officially begins. The match could be won by pinfall or submission. Exiting the cage will result in a forfeit. Now, let the War Games begin!
Just don't look at where we got the idea from. Swear to God, don't look at it. It's an original WWE idea. Luckily, ladies and gentlemen, he will be joined by the meticulous Macho Man Randy Savage and Ted DiBiase, two individuals who will be able to carry him. Unfortunately, both those men will be locked inside of a cage, so their assistance will not be felt for some time. So this will be a very interesting first few couple minutes of this War Games matchup. Zeus looks to be surprised, or perhaps confused. What he's even doing in here. Oh, we see that they're already in the cage. We saw Dolph Ziggler and Seth Rollins out there. The best individual to be left alone with. KO representing the greatest country out there, greater than all others. It's in the national anthem. No one can question it, and no one can hope to dismantle it. That is the greatness of Zimbabwe. Otherwise known as Canada. Legal fact, check it out. Isn't that precious, ladies and gentlemen? Zeus actually has a theme song. Well, here we go. Both men starting in the same ring. Let's see who has the advantage. And nice, Kevin Owens taking Zeus down. Oddly enough, JoJo did not want to be a part of commentating on this one. Not certain why. So it looks like it's up to me. Zeus taking things slow. Classic style wrestler. And Owens, though, taking him down. DDT, middle of the ring. Spikes his head. And Zeus attempting to just throw himself at Owens. If all else fails, use your body as a weapon. As I've said time and again, and even the referee has no desire to watch Zeus compete. Oh, Jesus! Oh, just throat catching the bottom rope. And Zeus with a hefty kick to the knee catches Owens and sends him straight to the other side, or straight to the other ring. And Owens with Zeus up, just parades him around off the top rope, giving him a taste of his own medicine. And will Zeus have help coming? A big ominous lighting effect here. And it looks like, yes, Ted DiBiase, Zeus has some assistance, and DiBiase will not be coming in alone. DiBiase, get the tables. You may want to hurry there, Ted. Clothesline to the back of Zeus's head as DiBiase just really taking his time here. Well, he manages to come in, realizing his partner is getting dismantled, and Owens just punches him in the face. Just walks right over. Empty shot sends him facing Zeus. Zeus unaware of doing anything. And Owens fighting back, and DiBiase from behind. He's going to need a partner soon. But is it a partner that he can trust? Table is still set up on the side of the ring, and DiBiase comes in to join up. And Zeus, though, spinebuster. Well, let us remind you, that table was set up by DiBiase himself. So Owens should be getting some assistance. He certainly needs it. And it is Seth Rollins. Rollins making his way to the ring, having to take the long way around. Dolph's going to be taking his time, coming in, I believe, with the kendo stick. And Zeus just picks it right up. Oh! And Rollins, not exactly helping his partner here. A little loss between these two, that's for certain. It's Ted DiBiase and Zeus just watched down at him. And Rollins just giving them more and more weapons to play with. We got one traditional ring and one hardcore ring. Now in comes Rollins. Zeus sets up the table. Or at least I suppose he was going to set it up in the corner. So finally, Owens has some assistance. Certainly took his sweet time. And already, already Rollins was on his way out. So we do know that this should be Macho Man. Bit of favoritism there. The referee opening the cage door a bit early. Kendo stick in hand. Kendo stick across Owens' face. And Macho Man gonna put a stop to all of this. Shots in the midsection. Not going to allow that DDT to come in. Not certain what else Macho Man has brought in. Looks like a steel chair. And Rollins fighting back, clapping the hands, and DDT! DDT onto the stop sign, and DiBiase getting a shot in as well. So Rollins having no trouble with Zeus on his end. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for Owens, who's being dismantled by these legends. Anytime Owens gets in some damage, another one comes in from behind. Ziggler just chomping at the bit, wanting to get in. He'll be coming in fresh, but for how long? Owens and Rollins in deep trouble here. And back onto Owens. And in comes Ziggler, just strutting his stuff on the outside. No real rush. Though not going for a weapon, just comes right in, and here we go.
Has officially begun.
Steel chair on Dibiase. Two-on-one situation inside the other ring. This thing is just absolutely full of weapons, and I have to say, Zeus was about to toss Rollins through the table or not, but the table's still set up. A pair of two-on-one situations, and the legends are absolutely dismantling the new generation. Or really the new generation. Series of shots there from Rollins. Turn around. Takes Macho Man down. And Zeus. I think Zeus just threw himself through the table. Oh, whatever works. I'm assuming that's what he thought. You know, it was like, saw a table and was like, oh, that's, I gotta go through that. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is just a preview of what to expect at Survivor Series, the War Games that determines the future of Whassup Wrestling. If the council is victorious, number one contendership to all titles whenever they deem, well, whenever they want, really. And no questions asked at that, though only one shot per title, thankfully so. However, if the resistance are victorious, then the council is disbanded. All powers of control stripped away from the figures of general managerialship. Kitty and Stephanie McMahon, they will just be standard performers, essentially. And Rollins almost pinned, and Ziggler finally going to go over and assist. Unfortunately, this leads Owens to Dibiase. And, oh, we're almost close to seeing Macho Man's patented elbow. We're seeing the same glitch effect that was working against Violence John earlier, although it would be working against him. Violence John was victorious. Kevin Owens trying to swing that stop sign, unfortunately. Couldn't quite do it. This thing just an absolute mess. No team in the lead. Stunner on Zeus. And Owens takes a shot from Dibiase. Dibiase just absolutely making certain that his team remains on top here. Owens just flops back. Macho Man and Ziggler. The magic that these two could have put together. And again, Owens in trouble, flopping about. Something is going on here, ladies and gentlemen. The 100th episode causing a tremendous issue here. No one can stand up to it. It is Whassup Wrestling at its highest. And Dibiase and the legends in control here. And almost Zeus almost winning it for his team. Another hand hold of Owens and down with a choke slam. Rollins trying to do what he can, but Rollins managing to fight back against Macho Man. Knee to the face. Here's the cover. Not going to get it, though. And Zeus standing over top Macho Man as well. Zeus standing with a stop sign, perhaps, and telling him to stop fighting. And DDT on Zeus. Here's the cover on Ziggler, though. Not going to get it. Midsection of Macho Man. In comes Rollins once more. And Owens sent between the ropes. The fight spreading across from one ring to the other once more. As Ziggler now, inverted atomic drop. Owens with a series of shots. His one arm beat a bad arm, but doing what he can. Here's the pinfall. And Zeus managing to kick out. And down, crossface on Macho Man. Dibiase not going to be able to stop it. Ladies and gentlemen, had to pause to smile on that one. And Owens with another pinfall here on Zeus. And that is it. Pinfall on Zeus allows Owens' team to come out here victorious. Kevin Owens, Dolph Ziggler, and Seth Rollins victorious here, but taking a hell of a fight here. A hell of a beating. But there you see it. What a contest, ladies and gentlemen. What a way to help celebrate Whassup Wrestling 100. Of course, Seth Rollins, who stole away Craig Stevenson's Universal Championship. Still a sour note in Whassup Wrestling's history. Former women's champion Amariil, the intergalactic sensation, here for more Whassup Wrestling action. The runner-up for the 2024 Queen of the Ring tournament, although some saying that Amariil had that one won, but basically gave it up in the end against Glory. As such, Glory did fight to get Amariil back into the title scene, and Amariil did what she could to prove herself into it, but unfortunately things did not go well for her there. Representative of WWE making her way to the ring. Coming on down. Huge advantage or huge opportunity for her. In the briefcase high above. Briefcase full of snickerdoodles. Perfect opportunity to just chow down, as it were, I suppose. is what this whole thing is about. Who will walk away with the case of sticker rules? This has been a while ago, ladies and gentlemen. Ripley, of course, not exactly much affiliation with the group anymore, being on her own. But a call back to perhaps better days. Ripley enters the ring. Slowly but surely enters the ring, one step at a time. Or just staring out at the crowd, but as you know what, ladies and gentlemen, here at Whassup Wrestling 100, you're Ripley in the backstage area, making your way to the ring, as word has it, scared the absolute hell out of Stan Stevens. Stan, who has not exited his dressing room since she arrived. Whassup Wrestling resident furry has been documented plenty of times before. Was pushed into this outfit during the first ever Snow Bunnies tournament as a punishment. Unfortunately for the punishment makers, Captain actually discovered a new side of herself, enjoying the feel of being a furry, and has, well, ever since embraced it, even going on to winning that tournament. And as you can see now, three of the council's punishment still coming out and even competing in her rabbit outfits and teleporting across the ring, giving everyone a bit of a scare. But that is just Catherine Neville here in Whassup Wrestling, the two-time Snow Bunnies tournament winner, and Snow Bunnies tournament will be coming again end of the year. Will she be undefeated once more? Time will certainly tell. See if we will have our only three-time Snow Bunnies winner, Captain Neville. Everyone all ready? Io Sky ready? Rhea Ripley ready? Catherine Neville ready? Looks like Amariil and Rhea Ripley going to go at it, and Catherine Neville being brought to the ropes by Io Sky. Catherine still brandishing her rabbit ears. Not exactly finding it comfortable to compete in full furry outfit, but I guess she can. Looks like Io is about ready to rip off the tabletop. And Amariil having a good idea. Precisely what this match is all about. Making her way around the ring with the ladder. Or just mainly she wants to go for Rhea. Indeed so. Made her way around the ring. Oh, down goes Catherine as well. And ladies and gentlemen, they are not fighting for any sort of contract or any kind of guarantee. Instead, as we know, as we called before, the briefcase full of a pack of sticker doodles. Hence why they're just absolutely killing each other. Who doesn't want a pack of sticker doodles? Who doesn't just want to say sticker doodles? And Amariil really wants those sticker doodles. I just like saying the word sticker girls, damn it. Amariil being, no, turns herself right around. Io Sky with the ladder. Just drops it down to compete, to continue the fight. And there's the C of the TLC. And down, back of the head onto that steel chair. Amariil's back also colliding with the top of that, just the chair itself. And Catherine sent into the far corner. And Amariil dropping her back. Catherine going low, Eel going high. That union did not last long, though. And there is the T. Amariil setting up another T. And Catherine fighting back. Sends Rhea into the ropes. And Io not going to let her do much more than that. So our TLC inside the ring. Well, TLLC. Leg drop DDT from Catherine. And from behind, Catherine thought that Rhea was taken down, but going to take a lot more than that to keep the Australian out. Nice suplex. And, it looks like Catherine Neville suffering the same effects here. Leg drop across the back of the head. Thus far, the two competitors who have fallen victim were victorious, so maybe that's going to be the same thing for Catherine. American Rana from behind Rhea on Io, and Io tossed to the outside. No one going to stop Rhea right now. Amariil, for whatever reason, Amariil calling for a tag. Catching Rhea from behind. And Catherine sent right back outside. She just works hard to get back into the ring. Amariil with the ladder once more. Setting it up far from under. DDT Amariil and Rhea now. And off the top rope. Rhea now, pump handle bomb, just flips Amariil away. Io standing up the ladder, face, gives it to her face, and Io climbing up high now. Catherine Neville still recovering on the outside, and Rhea Ripley. Catherine managing to close up that ladder. And I can't believe it, ladies and gentlemen. Catherine Neville has overcome the curse. Somehow, some way. What affected Violence John and affected Kevin Owens? Catherine Neville is not going to take the power. And she's going to win this one. She's going to win it on her own merits. And down, back first. Luckily, Amariil avoiding the table, the chair, even the ladder. Snap suplex on Io. As Catherine steps over the ladder, goes for the steel chair, and crashes down on Io's arm, which is resting on that ladder. Again and again. In comes Rhea. Onto the ladder. But Catherine pulling herself up. And Rhea's head colliding with close to the steel chair. And again. Neo Sky and Catherine Neville. Only two up right now. They're sent over the top rope, but manages to fight her. Wait, no! Catherine kicks her down and down! Back onto across the ladder. Not a good day to be Catherine. Rhea now sent over the outside. Steel chair knocked out to her feet. The table might be next. Amariil all alone. Perfect opportunity. for her to get up there and grab them snickerdoodles. Io Sky finally takes notice. Amariil with the hold of the ladder. Or the briefcase, sorry. And Io Sky fighting. Shots to the midsection. Finally, and Catherine shoves the ladder down. Stops Amariil from getting that briefcase. Little chair to the back. And again. Here comes Ripley. Steel chair in hand to Catherine. Amariil hoping or not, just setting up the ladder out of the way. Say that. Oh, and Io Sky back of her head. It's a power slam from Catherine, but Rhea, or at least attempts high kick on Catherine's face. I think Catherine was attempting to turn her around for the final nail. Rhea with the steel chair into the midsection, but in comes Io Sky. Into the face. Scoop slam from Catherine. This call back to Whassup Wrestling past. Another pump handle bomb. Clothesline taking Io down. Rhea with that ladder once more, setting it up in the corner. With Catherine and Io in the way. And Io fighting back. In comes Amariil. All four competitors here back inside the ring. Knees to the midsection again and again. Clothesline on Io and one more. And from behind. And dropkick to the face. And Rhea taking immediate control advantage. Amariil choking her up. And Rhea just sort of bonking Amariil with that ladder. Making her way around. This is what Rhea has in mind. And Amariil coming out to meet her, but Rhea catching her off guard. Just comes right back into the ring, clotheslining Catherine. And again, ducks underneath. And page from Amariil's book. Amariil catching her from behind now. Over the top rope. And clothesline on Io, just short arms her. It's like Rhea gonna go and focus in on Catherine, and Amariil going coming right out for her. And Catherine, no. Catherine countered out. And Amariil now countering Rhea and clotheslining Io down. And again, it's Amariil and Rhea. And Amariil giving Rhea a taste of her own medicine. And Catherine setting up the ladder. And make a climb. Io has her scouted, though. Catherine a bit slow, and certainly makes sense. All those shots on top of steel chairs, on top of ladders, and now hanging on for dear life. Unfortunately, she couldn't get the job done. The snickerdoodles still hang high above the ring. It's about as high as Amariil's kick there. And Catherine taking her down in the back of Amariil's head, hitting the ladder. I have to call it every time I see it, ladies and gentlemen. Series of shots, and Rhea flipped right over. Hard kick to the back. The shot and final nail finally connects on Rhea. Catherine has been waiting for that for a while. Table to Amariil's face, and Io Sky. Io Sky unchallenged. Rhea steadily getting to her feet. And I think that is it. Yes, Io Sky wins. She goes back with the case of snickerdoodles. A hard-fought matchup from all four competitors, each one of them wanting it. But in the end, it was Io Sky coming out victorious. I don't know what this says, but that is two victories here for WWE on Whassup Wrestling. And I suppose, in a way, we do have Violence John, so there's that. Time for our main event, the eight-man men's battle royale, and what a star-studded match that this will be. Shut up! I told you, Saxon, I warned you. I warned you what I was going to do to you. Talk about the competitor making his way to the ring. The man was a former world heavyweight champion. He defeated Superstar at Pride Falls, taking that title, ending the most monumentous reign of Whassup Wrestling's history, only to lose it just recently. The man won a battle royale earlier by eliminating all three other competitors to become number one contender to the world title, earning his second opportunity. That opportunity that wound up being victorious. The man is a living legend in the making. And this man is just a shadow, a pale imitation. Well, the crowd certainly doesn't seem to think so.
Newberry, Massachusetts, weighing in at 251 pounds, John Cena!
No doubt about it, the absolute greatest of all time. And nobody has been on top longer, and nobody has changed the game more.
You can't debate Cena's achievements, but you have to wonder, has Hollywood softened Big Match John?
You say the exact same thing back when he was entering the ring at the house show and then he lost to Superstar. The crowd there didn't like him either. This is Whassup Wrestling territory. I think the hat was just thrown right back at him anyway. But if this is the best you have to offer, WWE, we'll see. Show us the bald spot. Show it. Show it, you coward. Turn around. Let the camera see. As we await our next Whassup Wrestling competitor.
Looking forward to this one.
Seen a more self-centered superstar in my time here in WWE.
Well then, Byron, you've clearly never seen the WWE Hall of Fame.
Hey, everyone in the Hall of Fame has a reason to have an ego. This superstar, they haven't earned it just yet.
What the hell are you talking about? The man became Universal Champion at SummerSlam, a runner-up for the King of the Ring. the end of the reign, the year-long reign of Buddy. Why the hell am I even defending Superstar? Damn it, this is JoJo's job. JoJo, I know you can hear me. Get your mic on. Superstar is going to win.
Always walking around with a chip on his shoulder. He's going to use that anger against his opposition.
Who the hell are these jabronis you're replacing me with? I don't know. We just, the house show, guys. We got to make them, you know, earn their wages and stuff.
The underdog from the underground has returned.
And from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 212 pounds, Sami.
Faced off against Zayn when he began his WWE career a decade ago. We always saw the heart, but even I did not know he would rise to this level.
Well, Corey, whether he was cheered or booed, Zayn has consistently fought the odds, defied his critics, and now he is competing at his highest level.
No more bloodline. Sami Zayn is now fighting for himself.
Well, here's hoping. Sami Zayn, another proud Canadian. If he came out here victorious, I wouldn't mind it.
We are about to see something good.
We are about to be graced by the world heavyweight champion, the Natural.
From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in.
Tough competition, but this one likes to take things too far. Their matches can be downright gruesome sometimes. The way they go after their opponent. This industry isn't about being gentle, Saxton. You have to be a little mean sometimes to ensure the win. If anything, I think the intensity can be turned up in the ring.
Well, Tony J. Smith has been circling greatness for the longest time. Finally achieved it. Not too long ago at Fall Brawl, winning a 2 out of 3 falls steel cage pinfall only matchup against Max Garrett to become world heavyweight champion.
Determination on his face. He wants to show the world that he can compete on this high level.
Indeed, what he has been attempting, but I think successfully lately. Are talking him up, but that every word you're saying is just building the target higher and higher and larger on him. An elimination on Roman Reigns is going to be a tremendous feather in the cap for any of these other 7 competitors.
Roman Reigns is ready to continue his unparalleled domination.
We'll see if he can survive this one. Again, 7 other competitors, and you're just building him up. Making it clear that an elimination will be a tremendous thing for them.
This guy is the real deal.
Indeed, he is former Universal Champion Buddy, making his way to the ring. Recently lost his title back at SummerSlam in a triple threat, but and continued the dominance.
Weighing in at 272 pounds.
WWE Universe already reaching a fever pitch upon their arrival, and we are just seconds away from a highly anticipated match.
You just won't acknowledge his name, will you? You won't acknowledge Whassup Wrestling for all the contributions that we do. Without us, you wouldn't even be here. None of us would be here celebrating this monumentous event, this 100th episode. You, the three of you, make me sick. You kiss ass to your own superstars, but you won't even give the light of day to any of Whassup Wrestling's grandest stars. You know what? I'm not surprised. But he is always ready to compete. As I said, one of the longest reigning Universal Champions in Whassup Wrestling history, won the title back at a tournament, the King of the Ring tournament, the 2023 King of the Ring. Making a turnaround for his career. Well, spoiler, I mean, he did. To such a point now where he can't lose the title until WrestleMania. Any champion can't lose the title until WrestleMania. Well, yeah, because the last time he was in the company, he was basically relegated to barely intercontinental title status.
Here we go now, an old-fashioned battle royal. Talk about a truly chaotic match.
Yeah, it's very interesting that Tony J. Smith and Max Garrett are going at it.
We might just miss a few big hits here and there. That's how chaotic these kind of matches get.
Side rush and leg sweep.
And Buddy and Roman Reigns, what a contest that would be.
That well scouted. Oh, right in there.
Back elbow completely cuts them off.
Beautiful suplex.
Ripping and tearing at the face.
A familiar, gruesome sight on the face of the American Nightmare. Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
I think Tony J. Smith has been busted open, but you guys don't seem to care about that.
Big counter from Reigns.
Cena just actually getting pummeled in the corner.
For underhanded attack there.
What Zayn got planned?
And that canceled out Reigns' offense.
DDT, well, how could you not see that coming?
Uh-oh. Fisherman suplex. Nice.
He reverses it. Able to counter.
He's fighting his way from Cena.
Good measure.
And Smith over the top rope.
He had it scouted.
And saving himself from elimination.
Fall by a lariat right to the face. Nice counter by Cena.
The champion against Universal Champion here.
Tough position to be caught in here.
Piercing the throat.
And Superstar narrowly, no. He holds on.
Floor you.
Speaking of flooring, Cody Rhodes taken down.
Sami Zayn starting to struggle.
And Garrett there. In trouble here, close to the ropes.
Elbow after elbow.
That was Cody Rhodes and Superstar.
In the corner, and he's able to reverse. Uh-oh. Look at this.
Uh-oh.
Sami Zayn, take down. The Koji clutches him.
Well, there's no submissions in this matchup, but, you know. And absolute power is on display.
Sami
Zayn versus DDT.
DDT. Close right to the back of the neck.
And in comes Buddy. Right on top of Reigns. Bloodline reunion. Imagine that Buddy will be having his eye on Garrett at some point. Well, it was Garrett who eliminated him from 2024 King of the Ring. And Cena almost eliminated. But let's focus on Reigns. And down goes Zayn. Buddy was trying to take out Superstar from behind. Eliminations thus far.
Serious jeopardy for Rhodes.
Saw it coming and
hooked up. Shin breaker. Oh, what a shot.
Nice high kick to Cena. Marine's trying to get back into it here. Superstar focusing again on Cena. Picking up from where they left off in their house show. On Buddy, taste of his own medicine. Oh, well, sorry, I was a bit late there. I didn't know I was supposed to get in on it. Still no eliminations, but when they start, they'll be quick. Top rope, quickly back into the ring. Cena, though, and Roman Reigns takes it from Garrett from behind.
This could be it. A back suplex.
A huge surprise there.
Cody Rhodes has been eliminated.
And out goes Cody Rhodes, WWE being taken out. Sami Zayn on his own here.
DDT lights out, and Sami Zayn reverses it. Oh, this could be the end here. Swinging the elbow to halt the offense.
Bit of revenge here for King of the Ring. And indeed so.
A competitor has been eliminated.
The competitor was Max Garrett. You said his name before. Buddy almost close to eliminating Zayn. But Zayn fighting back. Saves himself. Superstar on Smith.
Nice suplex. Vertical suplex. And more attacks to his core could hinder his offense.
Like I said, when the submission starts, they're going to come in and starstruck on Smith.
A match-winning move, guys. Caught all that with his face, and now Sami is bleeding good. Hooked up, DDT. I'll tell you this, guys, no competitor here is looking to give in. It's going to take a lot to end this fight.
We are just seeing sheer perseverance. Nothing is being left back.
And Zayn fighting back, but no one there to finish the elimination. A superstar, no, through the ropes.
Out to dry.
Suplex on Buddy. Spending too much time taunting. staring out in amazement that he's able to do that.
Leg lariat with the arm wrench. Very nice.
And he's pushed into a weakened state now.
Could be signs of trouble for him here.
Sharp elbows to the body. Sure where to take him. Looking to fight his way out.
Foot DDT.
And Superstar looking to take Buddy out here. But Smith coming in from behind, taking down the Universal Champion.
And he's on the offense at this crucial moment in the match.
He knows exactly what's at stake at this moment.
And now Buddy, seen though, stopping him.
Oh, a combination! Enziguri! Beautiful teamwork.
It's certain that Smith wanted the teamwork, though.
Oh, and a right hand for good measure.
Superstar set up against the ropes. This could be it. Over the top rope, and yes!
The impact of that. That's his go-to move. Can he finish this off? Unbelievable.
World Heavyweight Champion eliminating the Universal Champion. Clothesline after clothesline. And down goes Buddy.
Raining down right hands.
Zayn might actually survive this. As Buddy and Smith continue fighting.
Oh, look at this. Arm wrench. Beautiful back kick. Oh, a flurry of strikes. Oh, it's coming.
And no natural selection.
Devastating.
Now natural bringing Zayn over across the ring.
Oh, what a counter.
Sami fighting back. Sends him into the corner himself. Goes for the elimination now. Zayn make it one-on-one. Zayn being brought down. All those shots could be it. And Buddy, gorilla press. I don't think Zayn can save himself here. We're down to two. Former Universal Champion and the World Heavyweight Champion. Buddy could be looking to win this one quick.
Elimination time.
Tony holding on. Holding on tight. Over the top rope. Holding to the bottom. This could be it. Buddy kicking and kicking. And there we go. Buddy victorious here. Tremendous victory on the former Universal Champion.
We're going to be hard-pressed to see a better match than that. Here's another look.
Hefty competition. Three of the WWE superstars eliminated in quick succession. Sami Zayn doing what he could to survive.
Here is your winner.
What a way to end off Whassup Wrestling 100, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us for the longest stretch of wrestling history, bar none. And we look forward to seeing you for more Whassup Wrestling in the future. I'm Wally Weasel, and JoJo is somewhere, and a few house show guys. Good night.